Destiny is not a matter of chance. It is a matter of choice.
Hey everybody, thanks for watching. I have here the new release, the third release of the Destiny series from Destiny.com. This was sent to me by the president, Trenton McKean. He reached out to me and said that he liked my videos. He was a subscriber to my channel. And he offered to send me this in exchange for a review. And he graciously offered me to keep it. So I have to make that statement in this video. So anyway, this is the shield, and like the first two, on the obverse is the knight. It's done stunningly well, both minting wise and the illustrative design. You know, I showed these on my other two videos, the raven and the dragon. And you know, this is not high relief, but with the shading and the engraving and the wonderful minting of it at certain angles, it looks high relief. These elements really pop out. Trenton, we just had a good discussion about his philosophy on his life and why he started the company with him and his father. Him and his father started the company. And their whole reason when they started the series was to make an impression of artwork in the market, and they decided to use their coat of arms, which is actually the Raven, the first release. Their coat of arms. So this one is very well done. The antique versions of these are the best ones. I have a proof and a BU version of the Raven and also of the dragon, and the only difference be from the proof and the BUs. The BUs are limited to 10,000, a mintage of 10,000, which is pretty good. The proof versions on the outside ring has the proof finish, where the BU version doesn't. The proof versions and the antique versions are limited to 2,500. They do come numbered on the, they have a split edge, reeded and smooth, so they can put the serial number on there. If you order the first strike sets, which come with the three, you'll get the same number on the COA. The proofs are only available by ordering the antique version with it. And if you order that together, you will not get the same number. You'll just get them serialized. So that is a difference in how you purchase them. You can go to their website and see how they, what they have to offer and how they offer it. They've got some really good stuff on there. They've got their motto. They've got their mission statement. And they have a sale right now for Christmas. And they have sell some other items. They sell the coins, the air tights for this, for these, in case you break your air tight. They sell a plexiglass acrylic stand to put three coins in, and they sell a made in the USA wonderfully done wooden display case that is really nice to display the three coins. You know, they're expensive. These things carry a premium, but I think they're well worth it. I can see definitely the wooden display case with the three antique rounds presented to someone who's you know, made a wonderful achievement in their life, you know, someone in the military or someone who's done very well in their graduation, maybe a retiring leader in your company, or just someone that you know who is retiring who's done well in their life. I think the wooden presentation box for these three would look really, really nice. Anyway, on to this coin or round. Very artfully done, again by artist Roger Lovelace. Roger Lovelace. And the front depicts a actual event. The elements are of a historical event. Very artfully detailed. The shading and the engraving and the minting on this are real nice. There is the name McCain, 1588, which ties into Trenton McKean's family history. And the elements on the back are of an historical event that took place in Scotland. There's a Spanish ship with the sun rays and the clouds in the background, and the castle in Scotland. Very artfully done. This is just an excellent verse. But getting back to the reverse, the design that you all came to see is the shield. And this was, Trenton told me this was one of his favorite designs because it shows the perspective of the knight as he looks at his battles and what he endures. Once again, very artfully done. Look at the detail in this. Man, you can see the wire mesh under his armor. You know, you can see the riveting on the forearm brace. You know, the engraving on the wrist guard. The details on his shield, on his armor, on his thumb, his hand, the rivets and the etching. And there, as he holds his sword, he's able to look forward at the battle that's coming and the battles that he endures. And he's able to see the motto, Aventus Fortuna Luvat, which means favor, fortune's favors the bold. And he can see that as he holds himself up to protect himself and to look forward. And I like the way that the elements are here, the sword, real nicely detailed with wood grain, is behind the inner ring. And on this side, it is coming out of the inner ring. Real nice, and also so is his fist. Done well. You can see the nice wood grain again. And here you can see a knight that is sliced into his shield a little bit. Very good design. One thing I did notice with these COAs that I didn't notice before, it's the COA has a scroll in front of the design of the coin, and it is the design that is on the coin that you see. And just look at that detail. Just look at how well that's depicted. Very nice. There's the ship there on the COA. You know, there's the ship. There's a knight on the horse. There's a castle and an axe, and that's what you see here. Man, the detail to this is really nice. I did tell Trenton that I wasn't too enthused about the coin, the design, when it first was released. I just didn't see much in it. But after we talked on the phone, and he said that was fine, he said he would still send me the coin and just ask me to review it. But, you know, once I got this in hand and talked to him about the concept behind the coin, you know, the shield, you know, it's not only this knight's life, but it represents his ability to protect himself from the constant bombardment that he faces in his battles. And it allows him also to make a decisive decision on when he will strike. So, you know, the depiction on the website also states it's not luck that keeps him alive. It's by making the right choices at the right time. Through his actions, he chooses to triumph as he has tried again and again. He knows that within himself, he will never be truly defeated. Persistence with courage can exceed any bounds. Be bold. Be fearless. Become fortunate and take upon yourself the favors of fortune. Destiny is not a matter of chance. It is a matter of choice. So not only is this about the silver, but it's about making a better tomorrow for yourselves. And these coins, you know, kind of encourage you as to the goals that you set. So these are very well done. The antique versions are the best ones. But this is the shield. Very well done. I highly recommend buying them. They do carry a premium, but you know, you see a lot of gods and you see a lot of fairies and fantasy coins. And I think these rounds here are definitely some competition in the market. I think Trenton and his dad and Roger and the North American Mint have got a superb series going on here. Their new coins will kind of go into a different area. And he has released it, and that will be the Blacksmith. And for right now, there is a code that you can use to save 5% off of your purchase. And that code is Christmas, capital C-H-R-I-S-T-M-A-S, 2017, dollar sign, percentage point, exclamation point. And that will, and Trenton told me that will be good until the end of the year. So if you want to purchase any of these rounds, I highly recommend them. They're very well done. They carry a premium. Very well worth it.